Hi there, this is Alessandro. Welcome to my series of tutorial, where the goal is to make accessible even to the Global South quantum computing. I know that many people in the Global South have more urgent things, like being more IT literate or open their own, creating their own website for their own business. But we are going to be soon affected by the quantum computing revolution, and it's good if every country is not left behind. So I'm talking especially to boys and girls who just graduated from high school, and maybe they want to learn some new things, and they got passionate, and then they decided to study more these fields in line with other programs that are already running, like this one from Ames Ghana.
To support and mentor high school girls, which we will track over the years with the hope that these girls will lead for us in 10 years' time. They will lead breakthrough discoveries in science, and not just to add to the numbers.
So I'm going to show you how to access some resources for free. I said for free, or others almost for free, using quantum computing remotely. So in the sense that in the past, scientists were working on their own university or research institutes, developing those advanced optical computing hardware, which now, taking advantage of a cloud-style platform, you can access even from wherever you are. So you don't need to be physically at the quantum computer. You can be in the middle of nowhere, or you can be, I don't know, even in a rural area in Ghana, Guatemala, Cambodia, Italy, Norway, wherever you are. What you just need is a laptop and an decent internet connection. As I was saying, before quantum computing has for a long time been like a field only also limited to theoretical physicists or mathematicians, but now there are a series of aspects that are possibility that are open also to the people that doesn't have this formal education. And traditionally you will need to study like physics 1, physics 2, quantum mechanics, quantum field theory, and finally you will start doing maybe your PhD in quantum computing. Instead, what I'm trying to do is that we start from the end and you do just the practical things. And in this way, you will decide if it's something interesting for you, or if even maybe you have just the basic idea and maybe you start your own company, and what you will hire some good physics, some person with a good physics background. Are you going to win the Nobel Prize with the few introductory lectures I'm going to tell you? No, because you cannot compare what you learn in a series of YouTube videos with someone who has spent, who took all this degree and he spent his entire life studying these things. But as I was saying, this can be a start, so then you can be motivated or to focus on this career, or as I was saying, you hire someone or you create something with some other people, making some kind of other kind of jobs or following other possibilities related to quantum computing. So let's start our journey of learning, discovering quantum computing. What I'm going to do is, as I say, we are more focused on practice. So I'm not going to give you a lot of theory, so because I don't want to bomb someone who doesn't have a formal education in math or science or engineering about this. But I will need to keep at least the minimum once in a while theory. So for today, I just remind you what a quantum computer is. And it's that the main difference is that normal computers store information in bits, which can be 0 or 1, while quantum bits can be somewhere in between or being both 0 and 1. Like you are flipping a coin, and you know a coin can be either head or tail, while instead with quantum computer you are considering all possibilities in between. Going back to practice, there are several architectures you can access for free or almost free. And among these, there are two major families. So one is the quantum annealer, which is ideal for optimization problems, and gate-based quantum computers. Unfortunately, quantum annealer, with some exception, are not totally free. So for the moment, I will skip them and I will focus more on to one architecture which is mostly accessible for free, which is the IBM Quantum Computer. So since we are going to focus today on the IBM Quantum Computers, I will introduce you to a library called Qiskit, which is a Python library. Python has become the most dominant program language in many fields. If you don't know anything about Python, I suggest you learn that first. So, because in these videos I'm going to assume you already know how to use it. And I'm also going to assume that you have installed the Python 3.7. Qiskit, as I was saying, is an open source library and freely available. Once you know how to use it, you can do many things related to quantum computing. As I was saying, not everything, because for optimization still annealers are better, but you can start doing many things. So let's start. First, you need to create an account on the IBM Quantum platform. This is how the dashboard looks like. It's something like, and there is something also like Jupyter. If you never heard of Jupyter, I will come back to this later. So Jupyter is essentially a web page which can you run on your own machine, or in this case on the Quantum directly, and it executes code within this box without running the entire script. It's generally good if you're learning something or debugging something, because you don't need to run completely the entire program. The idea is also with how the IBM Quantum platform works, is that there is a way that you can connect your machine and run your own script in your own Jupyter, in your local machine. For doing this, you will need to get a token associated to your account. Now, I'm getting to the IBM dashboard and I'm going back to my computer. So if you open your terminal, now depending on which operating system, terminal looks different. So if you have Microsoft, can be in one way, the command line. In Linux and Mac, they have this kind of structure of terminal, because Linux and Mac are more similar to each other. For Microsoft, probably you're going to need Anaconda, or also if you want, also you can do it with Linux and Mac. There is something called the virtual environment, which I'm not going through today, but if you want, you might want to consider that before installing a library. Here, if you write in your terminal pip install Qiskit, it will start downloading something, and afterwards you will have your library installed in your system. Now, if you go to the terminal and type Jupyter notebook, be careful how Jupyter is written, notice how the spelling is, it will open a browser window, and it will be something like this, where first you need to create a new Jupyter notebook based on Python 3, and this is how the page look like. If you're going to do, we can assure that you have really installed Qiskit if you write this command and press Shift Enter. You will see that everything went well, you will have another box, or otherwise you will get some error. Now, one good thing is that you check which version you are, just to be sure that everything is kind of working properly. As you can see, there are many versions of library, because there are many parts in Qiskit that they've been developed, that they serve a different purpose, that I'm not going through this today, but another time. And the first thing you probably want to do is to run your simulator. Now, to do this from your own machine, rather than opening the IBM dashboard, you need to get the API token, which gives you permission to use the device while you're using just your own machine. So once again, you need to log in the IBM Quantum Experience website, and you should be able to see the page that looks like this. By clicking this top right bar and clicking my account, this is where the API token is. So I hide it, but you should simply copy this and import it in your Now I'm writing in my Jupyter account, and if you're ready to access the IBM Quantum Computer, you can see that device This was just a way to set it up and to connect to the machine. We haven't done any kind of application or anything. This was just to show you how you have to set up your machine with the IBM Quantum Computing. Then from next time, I will show you some applications that I use. Some stuff that I'm interested is like related to chemistry or drug simulation, protein simulations. And at least what you can do some of this stuff even on the quantum, on the IBM quantum computer. Not necessarily you need an annealer for optimizing a structure. But we'll talk about this other times.